Morning, guys. So it's day two to go to my classroom and try and work on setup. I just dropped off Charlotte and pulled into the parking lot of my school. So I have a few things I got to carry in this morning, and then I guess I'll get to work. It pretty much looks just like you saw it yesterday. I only piddled a little bit, and then I talked to some other teachers in the afternoon. So pretty much picking up right where we left off on the first day. All right, so I'm back here in my classroom, and I sat down for a little while, ate my breakfast, and talked to one of my favorite colleagues this morning. I'm going to be doing Lego robotics this year for the fourth and fifth grade students. So I was talking to him because he did it the previous years, and so just doing a little catch up. But I think what I'm going to start with today is going ahead and getting border up on my bulletin board and separating it out in the sections I want. So you can see here, I went ahead and started with my first section. And the way I like to do it is I basically measure out where one full piece of chart paper will fit in the section. So I just make sure it's big enough to hold a full piece of chart paper. That way, if I want to put up an anchor chart in the section for the subject, I can, but more than likely it'll be mostly word walls. So I'm going to go and finish doing the whole rest of the bulletin board now, and I think I'm going to do it in alternating colors. So I have this pink chevron and I have this blue one. I think I'm just going to flip-flop between the two, and hopefully that'll cover the whole thing and I won't need more border. So that's the plan. We're going to see how it goes. Okay, well, I got most of it done except for the very middle. I ran out of pink, so, and I was really, really tight actually on finishing the pink down here. I kind of had to piece together a few to get that one done. So I guess I'm gonna have to find a teacher store and get some border just for the middle part, which isn't a big deal. It's one of those weird things though that you start thinking about and you're like, I had enough last year, so what the heck's going on this year? But I did lay it out differently, so I didn't have to do double border because I didn't alternate colors like this last year, so I bet that's where the extra went. So anyways, I'll figure out some kind of color for the middle. And yeah, I'll just keep moving along. All right, so I've gotten up my bulletin board. I found some old hot paint bordette in one of my cabinets. So I put that up for the middle. That way I don't have to go buy any. And then I got all my little subject headers across the top. I also hung up my weekly, like, folder home name sorter pocket chart. So, like, all their work that's graded gets filed into those. And then I hung up my two maps that we use all the time during social studies. These I made myself just using the smart board and, like, blowing up a picture and tracing it on, like, butcher paper, like, white bulletin board paper. So, anyways, that's all I've really done so far. I don't feel like I'm working as fast today, but, you know, I'm just kind of catching up with a lot of people as they walk by. So, I think I might work on just finishing cleaning up these two cabinets and organizing them, because, as you can see, a lot of stuff just got shoved in there at the end of the year. So, I think that's what I'm going to work on next. Alright, guys. So, honestly, I've kind of hit a point in the day. It's about 1:30. I've probably spent the last hour just talking to, like, other teachers on my team because I'm just kind of tired and I don't know exactly what I want to do next in my room. It's looking good. Like, it's not, there's not a ton that has to be done at this point, but I know there is just still a lot of things I want to do for the way I like having things set up. But I'm really, really tired. I'm, like, at the point where, like, I don't know that I can get much more done today. But I still have three more days this week of just, like, free time if I want it to do stuff in my classroom. So I got the bulletin boards done. I got my maps up. And I got my file, like, pocket thing up. And maybe I'll just, like, go sit behind my, like, desk table area and just work on kind of organizing that, because that's like a sitting down kind of activity. So just as tired as I am today, that kind of sounds like a good way to spend my afternoon, is like a seated kind of easy task. So I'll flip you around and show you what it looks like right now. So right now, you know, as you can see, it's not like horrible or unorganized, but I have a lot of just like filing and sorting that needs to be done. I have all of these notebooks that I need to make sure they're all in the right order, because a lot of them are my I can statements and they might not be in order for the year. So I got to do all of that. I also am not sure what I'm using these tubs yet for, and so I don't know if they're staying there or not. And I got to figure that out. I need to reorganize a lot of these read alouds, and then I have a bunch that are over here in this basket that I took home over summer that need to get put there as well. So I need to figure that out. And then, like, I don't even know what's in these. I gotta just kind of organize and sort. And this would make me feel just, like, clearer minded if all this was done. So I need to do that. I already kind of set up this. I keep a lot of, like, my go-to books here. So that's what will be in there. I keep a few little pictures here, which I think I need to update them because Charlotte's 2.5 now and so many of these are still baby pictures. And then I need to start putting, like, my supplies in there for the year. But I also need to go through this because I don't know if you can tell from the labels, but I previously just kept, like, supplies in these, and that's not what I'm using it for this year. So I need to move a lot of the more, like, supply things up into my sorter, and this is instead going to be things for my guided groups. So I'll have, like, a drawer for each reading guided group and then a drawer for each math guided group with a couple of extras, and then also, like, my weekly copies and stuff for, you know, sorting papers. So anyways, that's kind of what I need to do, which means I need to reorganize all of this, and that just seems more up my alley today than a lot of moving around and, you know, busy work, because I'm tired. But it's looking good. It's coming together. That makes me happy. Okay, well, I am done for the day. It's about to hit 4 o'clock, and I feel like I don't have a lot of visible progress, but I did a lot of stuff that's like really meticulous and takes a lot of time and just like hands-on organizing. So I started working on that stuff, like I said, behind my desk, and I'll show you that now. So I was working on just like going through and trying to pull things out of these. I'm still not done, but I got a lot of stuff out of this cart and then a lot of stuff out of drawers. You can see I'm still working my way through a lot of it, but I started organizing and labeling this. A lot of people have these, but a lot of them have the ones that have like different size drawers. I just have this one because I used to use it to store brag tags in. But I'm not doing brag tags this year, so I decided to use it for just all the little stuff that takes up all the room in your desk. So anyways, you can see a lot of the labels that I've got so far. I like that I have one full row of just chart paper markers. I'm able to fit, I think, like 4 in each one, so I just divided it by color because I thought that was kind of a simple way to do it. I have a lot of like alligator clips. So I have a lot of drawers for that, a couple of just like glue sticks for me, some different wall mount things, hooks, command hooks and things like that, tons of paper clips, obviously, push pins, some different stamps I use, the little rings, I have a ton of those, and just a lot of random stuff like that. So I have more room and I'm not done yet, so I'll keep doing this later, but I'm done with it for now. And a lot of stuff got cleared out of this today, which is good because I need to finish doing that. I think all the purple and all the blue drawers are empty, and then one of the green ones is empty and one of the red ones is empty. So I'm almost done with that. I'll finish it tomorrow. And then the other thing I have to do tomorrow is go through all my word wall words, because I'm not going to use all of them. I'm just going to pull out the ones we are going to use, and then I have to make new science and new social studies ones. So anyways, yeah, so I got that to do, but then I also want to focus on my library starting tomorrow. So that's kind of everything I got done today and some of my goals for tomorrow. So hopefully you guys enjoyed day 2 of classroom setup, and I will see you guys for another one tomorrow. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe and like my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye.